A few months ago, I posted a series of videos about the Venus transit cycle that began in 2012 and ends in 2020. Here's a link to one of those videos if you missed it. In short, Venus has a connection to Bible prophecy in that it represents Jesus, Revelation 22:16. It shifts 144 degrees every time it passes Earth, the measurement of the wall of the heavenly city in Revelation 21. And the symbol for its passage cycle is found etched in stone in ancient Judea, along with the ancient spelling for Jerusalem. In this video, I want to take this mystery a step further and share with you more patterns I found in the Venus transit cycle. First, as you know, Venus is the second planet from the Sun, and its orbit is next to the orbit of Earth. Because it's closer to the Sun, it orbits the Sun faster than the Earth. Therefore, Venus regularly passes Earth. However, the passage of Venus does not usually occur on the same exact orbital plane as Earth. It usually passes slightly above or below Earth's plane. But every 100 years or so, Venus will pass Earth on the same plane, and it will be visible as a little black dot crossing the Sun. These passages of Venus across the Sun are known as Venus transits. Venus transits usually occur in pairs approximately every 100 years. That much science will tell you, but what science may not tell you is that these transits also occur in cycles. For example, the most recent transit occurred on June 6, 2012, in front of the backdrop of the constellation Taurus. In 2014, it passed Earth in front of the constellation Sagittarius. In 2015, it passed in front of the constellation Leo. In 2017, it passed in front of Pisces. In 2018, it will pass in front of Virgo. And in 2020, it will pass in front of Taurus again, completing a 5-passage cycle. This cycle, the passing of Venus beginning in one constellation and ending 5 passes later in the same constellation, is known as the 5 petals of Venus, or the Venus pentagram found in ancient Judea. For simplicity, I'm going to show these Venus cycles as simple lines. So here's the Sun in the center. This is the orbit of Venus. This is the orbit of Earth. And these are the 12 constellations surrounding the ecliptic. The 12 constellations of the ecliptic correspond to the 12 months of the year, but the numbers for the months are different for both the southern and northern hemispheres on the ancient calendar. So I've refrained from using numbers for the months and instead have put the actual constellation that is the backdrop for each month. I've highlighted the 2012 transit in yellow with an arrow to show that this transit across the Sun on the same plane as Earth starts the cycle in Taurus. The next passage occurred in 2014 in front of the constellation Sagittarius, so we'll add that passage as a line here. The next passage of Venus occurred in 2015 in front of Leo. That's here. The next pass was in 2017 in front of Pisces. We'll put that here. After that, the next pass will happen in 2018 at the feet of Virgo. That's here. And then the 8-year cycle will complete in 2020 back in Taurus, which we already have here. So that is one Venus passage cycle beginning on the Venus transit of 2012 and completing in 2020. This cycle will continue to repeat every 8 years until the next Venus transit in 2117, at which time the cycle will start in Scorpio instead of Taurus. But for this video, we're going to go backward and look at the previous transits. As we know, the Venus transits occur in pairs approximately every 100 years. The 2012 transit was the second in the recent pair. There was also a transit in 2004, which started an 8-year cycle that ended in 2012. You may notice that the cycle from 2004 to 2012 is the same as the cycle from 2012 to 2020. The transit occurred in front of Taurus in 2004. The next passage was in 2006 in front of Sagittarius. After that, the next passage occurred in 2007 in front of Leo. The next pass was in 2009 in front of Pisces. The next in 2010 at the feet of Virgo. And the cycle completed at the next transit in 2012 in front of Taurus. These two cycles were exactly the same. However, the previous pair of transits were different. The transit in 1882 occurred in front of the backdrop of the constellation Scorpius. In 1884, the passage of Venus occurred in front of Gemini. In 1886, it passed in front of Aquarius. In 1887, it passed in front of Virgo. In 1889, it passed in front of Aries. And in 1890, it completed its 8-year cycle back in Scorpius. This cycle was also part of a pair of transits, the first of which began in 1874. And this cycle began and ended in the exact same places. The 1874 passage in Scorpius, 1876 in Gemini, 1878 in Aquarius, 1879 in Virgo, 1881 in Aries, and 1882 back in Scorpius. So the pair of Venus transits in the 1800s occurred in Scorpius, and their cycles matched exactly. But the transit pairs before that in the 1700s followed the Taurus pattern of 2004 and 2012. The transit of 1769 occurred in Taurus, the passage of 1771 in Sagittarius, the passage of 1772 in Leo, the passage of 1774 in Pisces, 1775 in Virgo, and 1777 back in Taurus. And again, this was part of a pair that repeated exactly from 1761 to 1769. But here's where it gets even more interesting. These cycles alternate every other century. The Venus transit cycles of the 1600s started in Scorpius. In the 1500s, it started in Taurus. In the 1400s, back in Scorpius. And in the cycle before that, back in Taurus. I followed these cycles all the way back 1,000 years, and they follow the same pattern. You can see here from 1032 to 1040, the transits started the same cycle as the transits from 1275 to 1283, which are the same as the transits from 1518 to 1526, which are the same as the transits from 1761 to 1769. Which are the same as the transits from both 2004 to 2012 and 2012 to 2020. The transits starting in the late 1800s match those in the 1600s, which match the cycles in the early 1400s, which match the cycles in the late 1100s. So the Venus transits not only start an 8-year cycle that repeats, they also start a roughly 200-year cycle that repeats. But above that, there's also a much larger cycle of thousands of years. You'll notice that the Venus transit of 921 BC began in Gemini instead of Taurus. And this is possibly because of axial precession. However, the transit cycles that begin in Taurus started around 183 BC and will continue to start in Taurus at least through 3956 CE. NASA doesn't provide the data after that year. That's roughly 4,000 years in Taurus the bull. All of this connects to the Book of Revelation and also to Egyptian mythology. You'll notice Isis was depicted with the horns of Taurus on her head, along with a circular object between the horns. And no one seems to know what that circular object depicts, but it appears to be a celestial body of some kind between the horns of Taurus. Author Patrick Jarrell indicated that the Venus passages were mentioned in the Egyptian Book of the Dead, and this was somehow connected to the transit of 2012. I'm not sure what to make of this yet, but I haven't heard anyone else mention the Venus connection to the Book of Revelation, which also connects to the Egyptian Book of the Dead. So I plan to look into this further. For more information on this or the Revelation prophecy fulfillments, click on the links here. Thank you to those who make this work possible. If you like this and want this research to continue, please consider providing support using the link below. I hope you're doing well, and I'll talk to you next week.